Hi everyone, it's me, Rolling Redneck. Here's the rest of the Let's Play Final Fantasy VI. Now, I did some shopping. Additional shopping after last episode, because when I tried to go out with all these amulets, I got fucked over. Locke doesn't need the sprint shoes because someone already has them, as long as one person has them. And these are the things you want to have the amulet for. If that bone attack hits you, you will become a zombie. And if all four of your characters are all your currently conscious characters become a zombie, you will die. In theory, I could end this with using a Phoenix down, but I want to save those. Okay. That is annoying. I guess it's nice to have another monster for the belt, I guess. Yes, sorry, I'm a little out of it. So a lot of people might have found my jokes about Setzer being a sex offender to be in bad taste. You know, if you are a victim of sex abuse, that's not a joke, and I'm sorry I hurt your feelings on that. But there are people who don't like, you know, the whole me judging a character by today's standards. You know, in the 90s, he might have been considered a slick and suave, dashing rogue type. But really, I find him to be a little insufferable. And a lot of people will say, well, you can't judge a character by the standards of today. You know, he's written in the 90s. But that's the thing. I think it's an important thing. People have been judging characters and writings and games by the standards of today forever. All art forms have had to deal with, you know, people thinking, oh, this doesn't age well. I mean, I'm sure there are, like, cave paintings that were thought to be really stupid by the cavemen who looked at them, but now they're in the British Museum, because they're considered, like, the best thing ever for the time. I just don't buy into the idea you should never judge past artwork by the standards of the current day. Because, you know, you can't judge something should be immune from judgment because they were made so many years ago, then we can't criticize anything. We can't evaluate how far we've come or figure out, oh, this probably wasn't great. And you also can't evaluate works that were ahead of their time. But again, that's just my little redneck rant. There are people who disagree with this view, particularly when it comes to things like the Civil War and pretending the Confederacy was good. I live in the South, so that should tell you something. Note to self, use Runic when fighting the Jokers. Again, somebody had a thing for clowns when this thing was made. Yeah, these do the same damage from the back row. Though, Locke won't get his free steel attack with it the way he gets the thief knife. That's a trade-off. On the other hand, does that make him the back row or the front row? I don't know. See, this is probably going to be a filler episode. I don't see anything of note happening in this town. And here we are in Vector. Doesn't look too friendly, understandably. Well, I guess that's one way to distract somebody. I think we're as ready as we're ever going to be for this point, though I might have missed shopping for something. Okay, this boomerang ain't that good. I'm gonna pause real quick. And actually, this seems like a good place to stop. We're now in the Magitek factory, and I guess we'll continue further exploration next episode. Have a nice day, like and subscribe.